I have always heard that Japan is a really kid-friendly destination, so I was excited to bring my three-year-old to check it out. If you Google playgrounds in Tokyo, you get a lot of this, this, and this. So is Tokyo actually fun for young kids, like toddlers? Is it worth traveling all that way? Today, I will share everything that I did with my toddler in Japan, what we did and where we stayed, to help jumpstart your own trip planning. However, there was one thing that really surprised me about Japan's kid friendliness. Stay tuned until the end to find out what it was. Getting around. I was pretty worried about moving through a bustling city with a small child, but it turns out the transportation is half the fun in Japan, and especially in Tokyo. This may not be your kid, but mine happens to have an obsession with trains or moving vehicles. That meant waiting for a train for 20 minutes was actually really easy. My son was fixated on the train platforms and could have sat there all day. Not to mention, inside the stations, going up and down escalators became a fun activity. You definitely will want to bring a light stroller that you can just pick up and go. You will find yourself in a pattern of getting on an escalator, taking a few steps, then getting on another one, repeat 4 times, literally. There are also cases where it's just stairs, but it's usually not a full flight of stairs. For most local trains in Tokyo, the Suica card is your go-to for a travel pass. It's also a card that you can use at Family Mart to pay for small conveniences. Pro tip is that you can also put it onto your iPhone's Apple Wallet. We got the red Suica card, which is made for foreigners because it doesn't require a deposit and expires automatically after 28 days. I believe all kids under 6 are free and do not require their own card. Activities. I'm going to talk through these in general categories. The first is indoor playgrounds or kid museums. I visited the Mibumachi Toy Museum outside of Tokyo in Utsunomiya, but I imagine they're all fairly similar. The great thing about indoor playgrounds in Japan is that they are kept extremely clean. They are strict about their no shoes policy, and everyone is quick to comply. At this museum, we found that their train toys were even organized in buckets, which made it very easy to play with. We found a nice variety in what they offer in the individual rooms as well. I found these grand structures to be quite unique, and I felt very safe having my kid play there while I sat on the sidelines. Pricing-wise, the kids were free and the adults cost only $5. Some examples of indoor playgrounds in Tokyo are Asobono and Playground Shibuya Kids, but we didn't get to visit any of these this time around. We did get to experience Little Planet in Odaiba, which is essentially the child version of Team Lab for adults. Instead of walking room to room at Team Lab Planets, Little Planet is a single room with activities and digital art shown throughout. The big hit was this ball pit and being able to throw balls at an interactive wall. I thought this place was fun for children, but a bit of a money grab. They force you to purchase a $5 membership card and are very strict on how long you stay. I made the mistake of paying for only 30 minutes, but it was impossible to drag my child out of there, so I had to pay for extended time, which is more expensive than if I had paid for extra time up front. Though Odaiba is on the outskirts of Tokyo, I liked that Little Planet was inside a huge shopping mall. If you have two adults, it's a nice chance for one of you to split off and get some good shopping done. If you're looking for a place to stay, Odaiba is home to a lot of the child activities in Tokyo. Boats. My toddler is constantly asking to ride a boat, but in the Bay Area, I haven't found a cheap way to do this for someone who's only going to be interested in it for 5 minutes. That's why we love the Sea Bass water bus that took off from Yokohama Station. There are also water taxis that take off from Tokyo, but we managed to kill 2 birds with 1 stone by checking out a new city and riding a boat. Yokohama is just a 20-minute train ride away from Tokyo and has lots of child activities too. The boat takes off directly from the train station. These boat rides are great because you can choose various routes. We chose the one that goes to Minato Mirai 21, a shopping district that is literally a 10-minute ride away. Getting to take a boat twice for 10 minutes each time was perfect for my 3-year-old. Animals. By now you have probably heard about the animal cafes in Tokyo. Some have hedgehogs, some have owls, others have small pigs. We didn't go to a cafe this time, but we did visit an aquarium. In Tokyo, there are at least 5 choices of aquariums for you to visit. We went to the more local Shinagawa Aquarium, which I felt was perfect for my toddler. It's not that big, and all of the animal exhibits were low to the floor. This aquarium is also at the end of a huge park, similar to Central Park. So there are lots of things that you can do along the way, like playgrounds, even a small beach, and make a whole day out of it. Where to eat? The great thing about eating in Japan with kids is that they are always free. Anytime you need to make a reservation in advance and pay per adult, you can assume that your little one can eat with you for free. At Family Mart, we stuck to the staples of onigiri, milk cartons, and he loved the smoothies too. At McDonald's, it was fun to try their unique menu items, and I thought their Happy Meal or Happy Set toys are better than the ones we get in America. In May of 2023, we got a Tomica aquarium truck that came with Assemble Your Own stickers. Interestingly, I saw that this truck sells on Amazon in the US for $8. For one of our dinners, we visited Utoya, which I know has expanded to New York City. In Tokyo, it is very much a family restaurant, which is why we appreciated it. As far as the broader categories of restaurants, conveyor belt sushi is a fun one for the kids. My toddler learned how to take trays off of the belt and enjoyed picking off the sashimi from the nigiri. In general, you will find conveyor belt sushi to be cheaper than America, and even the average restaurant there has a much higher quality of fish. We went to this particular one located inside Yokohama Station. We considered the idea of the famous robot cafes, but it seemed like something that's more suitable for elementary age kids. Plus, I was worried my toddler would get scared. We did go to a few quote-unquote adult restaurants like an izakaya place and Mizutaki, where there were less kids in the room. We used the screen time during these instances so the adults could enjoy a quieter meal when food arrived a bit slower. The thing about Japan is that not all restaurants allow children, which can be hard to navigate. In general, you may want to make a quick phone call to the restaurant if it is izakaya, yakitori, or a more upscale restaurant. So how kid-friendly is Tokyo? I found that there were a ton of amenities for young children and new moms. For example, in the Roppongi Hills Mall, there was a resting area for young families with a microwave, nursing rooms, and changing tables. There was also a designated play area for kids under two, shoes off, of course. At the Diver City Mall in Odaiba, I found plenty of changing pads as well. It's not uncommon to find a child-sized toilet and a child-height sink, even in an adult bathroom. For this reason, going to the bathroom was never an issue for us, and my three-year-old delighted every time there was a bathroom made just for his size. Where to stay? I'm no expert on Tokyo, but I can tell you that where we stayed this time near Roppongi Station was actually really great. Not only was it a 2-minute walk from the train station, but I also did a quick Google search for my hotel and found several park options that were more than just one place structure. If you're coming from the United States, you're likely dealing with jet lag and early morning wake-ups. It was nice to be able to go outside and find something outdoor for the kids to do while everything was closed. We stayed at Kandio Hotels Roppongi, and we saw a lot of families staying there. The breakfast spread will also have lots of things your child will like to eat. In general, I do think hotel breakfasts are worth paying for when traveling with young children, as they often want to eat right when they wake up. One lesson I learned the hard way is that Japanese hotels don't do early check-ins, so transferring hotels can be challenging if you have a toddler who is still taking one nap. On days when we were changing hotels, we were forced to do a stroller nap. Most hotels in Japan will make you pay an extra fee if you want to check in early. Before I get into the surprising thing I noticed about Japan's kid-friendliness, please remember to subscribe to the channel if you want to see more videos about motherhood and traveling with family. So far, so good, right? Lots to do and lots to eat for both adults and a toddler in Japan. But here's what was really surprising. I've always known Japan has a strong culture of politeness and respect, but I was way more sensitive to it with a 3-year-old around. I found that eating in most restaurants felt like we were in a library, even if there were other kids around. I don't know how the parents do it, but Japanese children are extremely well-behaved and don't seem to make a peep, ever. I felt like I got a lot of eyes when my toddler was speaking at anything above an inside voice. A lot of the young adults in train stations acted like they have never seen a child before, and they definitely didn't have a lot of patience for 2 or more toddlers running around. Restaurant staff tended to be very attentive too, and came to wipe things down when water was spilled or fork was dropped, which, if you have a toddler, you know that happens a lot. These were the moments where I felt the most American, when my kid wasn't 100% respectful and quiet at all times. The locals will never say something out loud, but they will notice. They're pretty strict about the shoe rule too. Even when my toddler took a nap while we were at a restaurant, they requested that we take off his shoes that were touching the bench that some people sit on. On the other hand, I have heard from locals that older people in Japan like to interact with kids on the street, which is not something you see in America. Maybe in Tokyo, we were surrounded by more of a younger crowd. I don't judge them for these expectations, though. It's part of Japanese culture that also makes Japan a really comfortable place to travel with kids. It's so safe, so clean, and so organized. So that's my guide to traveling to Japan with a toddler. I haven't done a lot of international trips yet, but I have a feeling that Japan will stay at the top of my list for years to come. With all the food, trains, and things to see, I know my toddler already can't wait to go back. Thanks for watching!